Hotep, Hotep community, welcome back. It is Thursday. I am the Metaphysical Morpheus, aka Shook Shock, Rev Shock, Shook Shocker, Shocktimus Prime, and of course, Shockalicious. It's Thursday. That means we are back with our elder on Shock Metaphysics, First Frequency of Oneness. Welcome, 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 everybody, and welcome back, our beloved elder. We've got a heck of a conversation to have today, as well as an amazing PowerPoint presentation that you have developed and a PDF that I happened to get a chance to read ahead of time. And boy, did you bring a lot of great information and probably information that I am certain no one else on the internet has picked up on and has talked about to date. How you doing, Baba?
I'm doing out fine. Just a little cold out in this winter. So, the freezing and all that type of stuff is going on. So it's getting to be wintertime. You know how it is up in Illinois.
I do. You know. I don't miss it, but I do know what it was. 40 years of that, and I had to get out. So you got an opportunity. I told you on Monday, my queen treated me to on my solar return. She treated me to see Wakanda Forever. So I went down and I saw that. I had some issues, and it was very entertaining, very beautiful. Cinematography was absolutely incredible. Right. Which is part of when you look at it and understand the propaganda machine. In music, it's about getting a beat that gets Black people hooked, and then you program them with the lyrics and the binaural beats. With cinema, it's immersing you into a universe where you're escaping and you get an opportunity to see yourself, hopefully, in some of the data. But part of that, the pro and the con of that is that sometimes you get an opportunity to watch these programs and you get programmed. You get pre-programmed. What are your thoughts on that, Baba?
They work on a subliminal basis. They work on that.
Yeah, that's mind. It.
And yes. I think about back in the day when we used to go to the theater when I was a kid, and they said they would use the popcorn, and they would put buy popcorn on the reels, but you wouldn't see it, but your subconscious mind would see it, you know. I'm very flabbergasted because, you know, the movie, many people don't believe is going to really make that much money. They believe that that they may not get that follow up, even though I think it was a well produced movie. You know, oh damn, man, that is some. It is super propaganda. It is super propaganda.
Yeah, it is. There's a lot of hidden stuff in there, and if you're not paying attention, it will bypass you, which is what it was supposed to do, right?
Yeah.
I also have to say this. Last night I did a show with my brother Harrison. Anderson from Melanated Convo, shout out to my brother, and we had to comment on Lupita. I don't know what's going on with Lupita, but she is just getting more and more beautiful every time we see her. She is absolutely stunning. That's true. That's true. My queen knows. I told my queen, I'm a grown ass reverend. I just want you to know that is a beautiful. African first frequency specimen, if you will.
Listen. When you look at all these muscular women, you know, and then you see a woman with she has curves. And,
yes. Yes.
And the thing is that she has curves, and she doesn't know how to use makeup, but she has very nice curves.
She doesn't need to use makeup. She is gorgeous.
Oh damn! I always. Well, I was poor because my wife used to. Use I like to at least have lipstick. I want to see this. Oh, baby! I like to see that.
I ain't mad at you. Oh, that's funny.
I think also that when you look at Lupita, you know, she did she was doing a video when she was dancing around all the time. I think the thing about her is that you feel her heart, you know. You feel her heart.
Yeah.
You feel that she's an she's the type of woman you might could relate to, you know. A lot of women nowadays you can't relate to because the fact is that, I don't know, I'm not out there, so I don't know. But the thing is, this is that a lot of people, they complained about the fact that it took them an hour to show her in the in Black Panther.
Oh, that's a good point. That is a good point.
And a lot of people felt that that they should have showed her earlier, and they were going all over the place. You know, a lot of the Latinos, they really really hate the film. You know.
Oh really?
Oh yes, they hate the film because she made Namor. Let me roll that R. Namor. She made a. They said that, you know, remember during the fight scene, you know, Namor, he had to bend the knee, and then he, you know, she tore off one of his wings.
You know, right, remember she tore right. One of his wings. Well, that was Siri. That wasn't Lupita.
Yeah, that was Siri. And so then, but what I'm saying is that they feel that the Latinos should have had a better presence, but see. The problem is that.
That's part of the propaganda, though, isn't it? That's what we're going to be. That's what you're going to be talking about and teaching us today.
In a way, it's part of the propaganda. But you have to understand is that Latinos, they shouldn't even get upset about it because the Latinos are not related to the Mayas. The Latinos, the Chicanos, they're a creation. They're mm-hmm. a creation. You know, they're not a. They're a new population. They didn't exist. It wasn't mm-hmm. any Latinos. Chicanos in Mexico. Remember, they're a product of the Spanish raping those black and Indian women, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
then they produce these offspring because, see, genetically, most Chicanos, if you really did a genetic test, most of them all carry black genes and stuff. They don't know it because mm-hmm. they think they're white. Mm-hmm.
Or they're in denial of it, and they identify as white in this country.
They have to identify as white, but see, they're a mongrel. They're almost like mulattoes in a sense, but they're a mulatto that was created over time. You know, I guess that's what would happen if mulattoes just married each other. I'm not saying that from a racist perspective, so
sure.
Don't go to YouTube.
But it's a later population. It's not an indigenous population.
Yeah, it's not an indigenous population. And see. The thing is that a lot of Chicanos they have a problem with us because the fact is that okay, if we look at an Olmec or if we look at a Black Maya, we can see ourselves, but they can't mm-hmm. they can't see themselves as an Indian because most of the Indians are real brown, you know,
mm-hmm.
and most of the Indians are brown, and so that's a little terrifying. But the point is this though is that the European this whole Wakanda. Forever is a very diabolical thing. It is so full of white supremacist ideas. It has the various agenda. You know, the only thing they didn't want to make a mistake and have too much homosexuality in it. So they mm-hmm. just had I think it's Okoye or whatever. You know, the general, they had her in a sense. Her mm-hmm. lover just kissed her on the forehead,
mm-hmm.
you know, because they know that those other shows, they had so much homosexuality in it, they didn't make any money, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So this time they kept that down. But the other things were in there, you know, the weak men, you know, feminized men.
I love what Baquette says. She's like, exactly like Mulatto Adam, not Black Adam, but Mulatto Adam.
Yeah, they
so
all,
bad,
yeah.
Sean.
Yeah, Mulatto Adams, you know.
Ah, that's funny to me. That cracked me up. Thank you, Goddess. I needed that. What I want to talk to you about, though, beloved, is and I'll put it in the chat, but also it's in the description. What I love about your mind is that you are a researcher in your heart, and so you bleed research and. You see things and discover things that we don't see, that we need to see, but you're teaching us also how to see. Kind of what you talked about last week in terms of you're helping us give us the ability to make visible what's invisible. And that's why this conversation is so radically important. And I think this PDF is so radically important because you found some things out about Biden in a private Zoom meeting that the people I don't think really know. And we need to know and we need to understand what is going on we alluded to this months and months ago, early on in our working together. But we've talked about this divide and conquer strategy. We've talked about how they create a buffer class to come in. And we said we have to get our act together, because if we don't, then there's going to be a new set of rulers that's overseeing us and protecting, quote unquote, whiteness. How am I doing on that, Doc? Oh, I know you froze too. Oh, doggone it. We're having some tech difficulties, family. So we wait for Doctor to come back and unfreeze from that, because this a lot of people are coming in, and this show, of course, you know, my show, they're trying to hit me up. Go ahead, Doc.
Well, something's froze. Okay. Yeah.
Wow. So now your audio is choppy. So let's try to figure this out.
Very interesting day, because we're having an attack.
Okay, so I am going to mute. So why don't we do this? Because I see that we're really having an attack here. Let's do this. Doc, why don't you get your, if you have any more to offer, let's do that. But I'm going to put the PDF in the chat. And I really want to talk to you about this, what research you uncovered. And also just how you saw the film, the underlying sinister, if you will, message of the film. Because it was multiplicable. It wasn't just one thing.
Yeah, it was. It's an underlying theme in the film, because many people easily recognize the usual Hollywood agendas. You know, feminizing the men, making the virilizing the women, and stuff like that. And many people saw that it was really a continuation of the Woman King, but it was a much more diabolical plot there, in the sense that it was trying to work on the minds of our children. It was trying to make our children choose a path of passivity. Yes, passivity.
Yes, I saw that.
A lot of people, when they look at the film, they will just say, this is the same old stuff. I'll talk to my kids when they get home, and I'll explain to them that this is just propaganda. But again, it's still a good film, so I want my kids to see it. And I'll let my boys know that, you know, at the end, they showed you that. I'm going to give some spoilers out there. See, I watched the movie. I had a bootleg copy, so I'm going to say some spoilers. We find out.
They're coming for you. They're knocking on your door right now. They're coming for you.
Hey, my daughter's out. My daughter's she's been with me the last couple of days. So you come out here, that's the police, Mike.
Oh yeah, the popo gonna get you. Come on.
That 38 is at the donut.
I love it.
And to get back to the what I was talking about is that it's very diabolical, because see, when you really see that this is more diabolical than any other film that they've done in terms of trying to brainwash our youth. You know, yeah, and because of the fact, in the sense, is that the imagery is so startling. You know, for example, here we're having one of the greatest heroes in the history of the world. They, you know, the Wakandans, they fought in the Infinity Wars. They fought in all these wars. They fought aliens, a super army. They and Black Panther, he was a member of many of the he helped the Avengers a lot. And that one Avenger show up at his funeral. Get out of here.
Ooh, see, those are hidden gems. Yes, very well done. Well done.
See, but they couldn't do that, because if they would have been, in a sense, if one of them would have came, then they would have had to have them in the film, and they didn't want to spend that much money on a Negro film. But then on top of that, they had this guy who could just sneak into Wakanda. This is the most secret state on the planet Earth, and yet this guy, he can come in, and she's asking her guard, how did he get in?
Good point. Another good point.
Powerful. He goes, right. He's so damn powerful. Here's the Black Panther. Why couldn't they? let the brother die heroically? Why couldn't they let him die fighting to save Wakanda? Why couldn't they let him die, you know, just accidentally get killed trying to save a black child?
Mm-hmm.
They had him die of some sort of damn disease when Wakanda's supposed to have cured every damn disease on the planet Earth. None of it matches. But it was just in a sense to create some sort of erroneous. They could have made the movie. They could have had him in a sense, a new one come in. We know that he has a child now. They showed that at the end, and that was stupid. You know, they didn't even have his child at the damn at the funeral.
At the funeral, yeah.
And the mom knew, and his mom knew. Then the best actress in the whole film, that was the Queen Mother. She gets killed. Get out of here.
Get out of here. But not only that, my beloved, and here's something you and I talked about on the phone the other day. How are you going to kidnap me, kill my mother, and I'm going to do all of this research and development to figure out how to defeat you, and then I get the opportunity to defeat you. I even go to the ancestors, and my Killmonger ancestor shows up and says, kick that ass. And then when I have the opportunity to do so, after you've kidnapped me, killed my mother,
ruined the city,
I let you go.
Yeah,
I let you live. That is the same trope that when that idiot killed 9 of us in the Carolinas, and the next day. We were on there saying, "I forgive you."
And see that. Remember that. That's another trope.
Absolutely.
In the movies, we're either that super engineer, that super scientist, or we're always forgiving. And so here's somebody. Her city's been just about destroyed. Her mom was killed in front of her face, and the man who killed her mom, she has him in her power. She has a spear, and she lets him live. You know. But that's not even the more silliest stuff. When I go into the discussion, I'm going to tell you more. But this is how the Mexicans see it. The Mexican brother, they record Wakanda film. It is against the immigrants. Why is it against the immigrants? God. Well, this is what they do. They have Namor. They have him come up, and he's fighting Suri. And then Suri, what does she do? He's wet. And yet, Suri, she conquers him by putting a fire, and she burns up his back.
Okay. So the trope for them is being called a wetback.
A wetback. And that the way
that's what they're – so they're connecting all of those dots. That's interesting. Fascinating.
And so the Spanish say that, she was defeating the wetback by burning his back. I mean,
it is
so white supremacist. I'm telling you, family, this movie has so much white supremacist ideas in it. It did not, in a sense, just say that we're going to destroy black people. It also wanted to input some stuff on into the Latino mind to let them know that you ain't either.
Mm-hmm.
And so then it's very important to understand that. And when you look at me, I like the movie because I'm a Marvel addict. Mm-hmm. I try to look at most of the Marvel movies. And in fact, I can't wait till the summertime. So me and my wife, we'd always go see all the Marvel movies because we like anime.
Mm-hmm.
We like Japanese anime.
Mm-hmm. And
so then this is because that allows me to have my voyeurism. You see,
but sure.
For the Spanish reviewers to say that the way Suri beat him was to get his wet is the wet is the bird is back. It is so ironic, and it would take a Latino. It would take a Latino to really see that white supremacist idea in the film.
That is fascinating. I didn't until you started talking about it. I said, "Oh shit, that's the trope of the wetback."
Yeah.
Oh, that was good. That was good, Doc.
That's right. But see, but that's the whole point.
Wow.
It's so full of so many white supremacist ideas. Family had to understand is that this man is in trouble. We already see that every commercial has to have a black or a white person together, or a Chinese and a non-Chinese person. Everything is to create this multi-ethnic experience so that they can still maintain white supremacy or homosexuality. Because see, if you can get, you know, what did Dr. Francis Wellesley say? Is that their ultimate goal is to make all of us homosexual, because homosexuals don't produce children.
Right.
But
absolutely. Which is part of their agenda of depopulating the planet. That's part of their agenda. Which is auto genocide.
When you look at the census forms, I think it was about 50 years, you know, for a period of about five decades, every year they said that black people was only 10 million people mm-hmm. in the United States. Now, how could you be 10 million people over a 10-year period and you remain 10 million people over a 50-year period when people back in the 20s, 30s, and 40s were having 7, 8, 9, 10? I came from a family of 11. My wife gifted me with 6 kids, you know.
That's right.
And so then I know in the sense that we're very productive. We're very productive people. But now look at this. It is so terrible that even today, you know, the number one thing is a lot of our women who are pregnant, they're not getting the good services from doctors. You know, many of them are dying,
giving birth now.
Remember, I think it was Janae from London. Her research is on how they're trying to have the women have cesarean births, because I think if you have a cesarean, you might can have 2 children. After that, you have to have your tubes tied. if a woman gets her tubes tied, she's not going to want to have too much sex, because I mean it's that whole idea that once a month that egg drops, when that makes her feel fertile, and she wants to have that egg inseminated, so that can be a high point. And so then, but what they're doing is that they're working on trying to decrease our population through homosexuality, decrease our population by attacking our women. Look, dying in a sense, you know, even after they've had their children. Look how many black women are suffering, and black women are suffering, period. I mean, they're supposed to be superwomen. You know, and they're supposed to be the love of the European. And yet, even though they talk about the love of the European, they're not doing in the sense to make their health outcomes any better.
Not at all.
Because
well, you see, family, how it's freezing up and how they're trying to stop this thing. So let's just keep going. Be patient with us. We'll keep moving. All right. Keep it coming. Keep it coming, Doc. Yep. You're still freezing, and now you're moving really, really slow. Oh, I just love the technological interruption. It's called frequency interruption, fam. So let me, as it gets stable. Okay. Now I think we're back on another track here. Let's try it, Doc. Go ahead. Oh, no, you're still frozen. Why don't you get your PowerPoint set up? Get your PowerPoint set up. That'll give the internet a little time to catch up. And I'm going to send some shots out to the community. So I see Katrina Prater is with us. Of course, Go Travel Abroad. Sean is back with us. PJ, what's going on, my beloved? Edward Hines is with us. David Van Villay from, I believe, the Netherlands is back with us. He's our regular. Welcome. You're probably the only black person in the Netherlands. I mean, you don't think of black. Well, no, it's 2. Actually, in the Netherlands is also Dr. Tommy J. Curry. He had to move there because he couldn't get a university job here. Natasha Z, I see you out there. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Nathaniel Turner just tuned in. I want to send a shout out to Zachary Holmes, who was first on, saying first frequency B1. GD, I see you out there as well. David Boyd, Fire is Hot, Octo Thorpe, and Cheryl Lynn, Shade. Hey, Cheryl, what's going on, goddess? Edward Hines, I think I talked to you already. So we got a Nicole, High Vibes. Can't miss Nicole, High Vibes. Back with us. She was with us yesterday. Made from Above, Underdog Law is with us. What's going on, brother? All the way free. Welcome back, family and community. Yeah, we're having some tech difficulties. They're trying to stop us. And Amra is here. I see Amra. Looking forward to having you on and talking with you guys next week. James Hunt just came in. Panther Black 1804 is with us as well. All right, Doc, do you have your PowerPoint ready to go? Because I have a feeling it's going to be a little choppy going, but we'll do the best that we can. We're not stopping. As McFadden and Whitehead would say, ain't no stopping us now.
Ain't no stopping us now.
Okay. Well, that's why you do research. Really, I'm just saying. It was stick with PowerPoints and research, and we'll be fine. I'm just messing with you, Doc. Love you. I got your screen up. Let's hit your PowerPoint. And let's see what we can get. What we can get going here. There we go. Look at that.
Okay, Wakanda, white supremacy forever. The myth of a possible black and brown coalition. In this, we see some of the Aztecs. As we discussed in one of our earlier videos, the Aztecs were black. In fact, the Aztecs were Mandi or Mandingo people. They called themselves Malinque. But in a sense, you know, they called themselves the name that they called themselves was Mexica. And Mexica means the great black nation, the great black nation. And they were proud of their blackness, but as you can see, they tried to have a coalition with the brown people, but they had to usually, in a sense, beat them because of the fact that they were always trying to attack them. It's not in a sense. Some people like to feel that many of the Aztecs were racist. It wasn't that they were racist. It was just that, in a sense, many of the Mongoloid Indians were always trying to take their land away from them. Please join my Patreon. In the Patreon, you're going to find all of my slides. And the slides, in a sense, they're there. So any presentation I do on any platform, the slides are in my Patreon. I really appreciate my Patreon members. You know, one of the Patreon members, she was able, in a sense, to make me understand that it was not only in a sense that many black people, when they catch AIDS, that in a sense they lose in a sense their ability to understand who they are. She also pointed out the fact that many black people, when they catch AIDS, they lose their identity. Yes, they lose their identity, and because they lose their identity, they become so full of this whole idea that they can, in a sense, buy whiteness, that although they're outsiders, they feel, in a sense, that they can try to find an entity by trying, in a sense, to be white. And so I really appreciate you. Those of you out there who want to help support me in my research, please join my Patreon. If you want to support Reverend Matthews, join his Patreon too. In my Patreon, you're going to find the slides. You're going to find video guides where I explain how to go and look at my videos. And I have about 200 videos. You can go. My Twitter handle is at Dr. Clyde Winters 8. And, you know, I post things on my Twitter every now and then. Also, you can go to my page on YouTube. My YouTube site is Clyde Winters Afrocentric History Site. And what I have there is over 200 videos. And these videos will tell you all aspects of the history of black people. And then naturally, I'd like you to go there, check out the videos, and subscribe. You know, it would be very interesting if I could get maybe, 20,000 subscribers. And also remember to punch the subscribe button for Reverend Matthews. And on this platform, you know what? Punch that like button. We want more people to come. We want more people to get this history because we need this history. And that a lot of people, in a sense, aren't getting this history because right now they're only getting that a spoonful of history from the Eurocentrists, and they don't want you to know who you are. And then naturally, you can order my books at Amazon.com. And at Amazon.com, they have all of my books. And these books can help you to understand the Black experience. Black is recognized as a legal term in law. Many of the Aboriginals and the Moors and the Hebrews, they say that there's no such thing as Black in the law. They say there's no such thing as Black in the library. That's what in the Black Law Dictionary. But the point is that Black is recognized in the legal system. For example, the 2003 Supreme Court ruling in a redistricting case known as Georgia versus Ashcraft set the current standard for who counts as Black. Since this 2003 ruling by the Supreme Court, the definition of Black has included every person who identifies as Black. Yes, every person that identifies as Black on the census form is Black. Don't you understand? Stop it. Stop it. Stop.
Teach us. Teach us.
That Black isn't recognized in the legal system. It is. We've always been recognized. Even before they put the term Black, they also talked about the fact that we were the slaves. We had three. They recognized us as 3/5 of a man or whatever. But you have to understand, in a sense, that there is a legal representation. You Aboriginals, brothers and sisters, you Moors, brothers and sisters, you Hebrew brothers and sisters, do your research. That's one of the reasons why I've tried to set up this research program. I try to teach people research so that they can find out the truth about who they are and know, be able to move forward. But so many people, they're always waiting for the European to tell them where to go, tell them how to do stuff, that therefore they lose sight of who they are and what's really out there. You had to do the research. You had to do the research. In January, we're going to have another research class. I hope to see some of you guys there. Aboriginals, do not tell Karimio to join my class. I do not want Karimio to join my class. Because this guy, he knows how to find all those old books, and he'll probably write 1,000 books. I got 37. But he does know how to interpret the research. But he has some good stuff sometimes. But he can't interpret the research, so he gets stuff mixed up. So don't you dare! Don't you dare! Don't you dare! Don't tell Karimio, because if he pays the money, I gotta teach him. I don't want to teach him. I want him to steal, not know. He wants to acknowledge your Black African ancestry and mind, not heritage. We must be race men and women proud of our culture and African Black identity, Black ancestry. What is B1? B1 is unity with Maat. Unity with Maat. Dr. Marie Charles has noted that the Egyptians said, Kim Dejeti Maat, Kim Dejeti Maat, Kim Dejeti Maat. To be Black, speak you, Maat. I have not done wrong. I am not robbed. I have not stolen. I have not stained people. I have not told lies. I have not stolen food. I have not sullen. I have not fornicated with the fornicator. I have not caused anyone to weep. I have not dissembled. I have not transgressed. I have not discussed secrets. I have brought no lawsuits. I have not wrongly copulated. I have not struck terror. I have not transgressed the law. I have not been hot-tempered. I have not been neglectful or truthful words. I have not cursed. I have not been violent. I have not confounded truth. I have not been impatient. I have not cursed the God. I have not made extolling prayer. Kim Dejeti Maat. Kim Dejeti Maat. To be Black, speak you Maat. B1 is acknowledging your Black African ancestry and Maat, not heritage. We must be race men and women proud of our culture and African ancestry. What is FBA? FBA is not a group. FBA is not an organization. FBA is a lineage. A lineage. A lineage is lineal descent from an ancestor, ancestry or pedigree. As a result, we are descendants of the African and Aboriginal Blacks who built the United States. Yes. 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 Stop. 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 Stop denying your African ancestry. Yes. We've been over here for 100,000 years, some of us. Some of us have came over here between that 100,000 years up until today. But the point is this. We are ancestral African people. Don't let your heritage get you in trouble. Don't let your heritage allow you to lose sight of who you really are. Be one, be one, be one. We are Aboriginal Black Indigenous people, native to the United States. FBA ancestry is African. FBA heritage depend on our tribal origins and present in various states. Yes, yes, yes. Number three, Aboriginal FBA were the first slaves in the United States. Yes, the British. Sir Francis Scott, he came over here and he kidnapped our Black ancestors, our Aboriginal ancestors. He took them and sold them as slaves in Britain. And he gave a lot of them innocents blankets. And he gave them blankets with smallpox. And he gave them those blankets with smallpox so that when these white people, when the British came, they would find villages where they could, in a sense, just move into wooden buildings. Yes. They always teach you. They always teach you that the Indians, that the American Indians lived in teepees. They always teach you that the American Indians were a nomadic group. That was the Mongoloid Indians out west. We built forts. We built wooden houses. We had a very significant civilization, and next week I may discuss it. Number four, identity matters. They use such terms as color, minorities, African-American, to try to deny our ancestry as FBA. Yes, yes. You say FBA because FBA expresses who we are. FBA allows us to come together as one group of Black people, be one. When you say FBA, what you're doing is that you're avoiding all of those heritages. You're avoiding just saying, well, I just want to be with the Christians. F you, I want to be with the Catholics. Well, all y'all stupid. I'm a Moor. I'm a Hebrew. I'm the first of God. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Reverend Dr. Mather already told you that we're first frequency.
Facts all day.
If we're first frequency, that means that it's not just, in a sense, our Hebrew heritage. It's not our Christian heritage. It's not our Catholic heritage. It's not our Muslim heritage. Peace of your law. We are first frequency because we're God's chosen people, the firstborn on this planet. Everybody else is our children. Everybody else is looking up to you. And everybody else should call
speak
you
that
mommy,
truth.
Daddy.
That's right. That's right. Speak that truth.
Learn. 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 Learn who you are and what you are. During the Civil War, 200,000 FBA fought in the Civil War to free themselves. Yes, we fought to free ourselves. The European has given us nothing. Many of the people from the North, they began to desert. They began to run back up north. The South began, in a sense, to be winning many battles. And America was losing the Civil War. Lincoln needed to know what to do. He didn't know what to do. Frederick Douglass said, my people would be happy to fight for their freedom. And what did he do? He didn't want to give us a gun. They didn't want to have you with a gun. The most frightening thing on the planet Earth is an FBA with a gun.
But he bring that truth. Yes, sir.
He had to do it. And the war turned around. Those Black troops in the Union Army began, in a sense, to fight and push those Confederates back, like Bush, them Confederates back. They pushed them back to the damn plantation. They took away, they lying. Because we were fighting those dirty Confederates. FBA culture is American culture, the food, the music, the language. I don't have to tell you more. When I went to university, they come telling me that Black people didn't have the FBA didn't have in a sense any culture. They told me FBA lost their culture during slavery. That's a damn lie. We didn't lose our Indian culture, and we didn't lose, in a sense, our African culture. And then we created American culture. My father, he taught me the Aboriginal tradition of the land. My father taught me to love the land. My father taught me how to grow corn. He taught me how to grow beans. He taught me how to grow, in a sense, the three sisters, corn, beans, and he also had us grow a lot of squash. I didn't like squash. But anyway, he taught us the three sisters. My father taught us to love the land. My father, he taught me how to go out and hunt. My father, he taught me how to clean squirrels, how to make it in the sense, how to hunt a squirrel, hunt a rabbit, how to clean that squirrel, how to clean that rabbit, how to get the wild taste out so we can survive. Yes, sirs. Yes, sirs. Yes, sirs. We are the Aboriginal people of this land. FBA built America before and after Europeans came to the USA. We built the roads. We cleared the land. You know, I see some people in the chat. They say, when I said that Black people had stone pyramids, some people say, Dr. Winters, stop telling that lie. You know they had just mounds. But on top of the damn mountain, they had a stone pyramid, you dummies. But they took those pyramids. They broke them down. They took the stones. They used those stones, and they used that dirt to build up the railroads. They put it under the railroad tracks to establish those railroad tracks across the country. Learn your history. Learn the type of civilization we had before the European got here and the civilization we had when the European got here. Stop putting in your mind that if you were a Black Indian, you wore a damn feather in your damn hat. Stop putting in your mind that Black people lived in teepees and that Black people moved around on a horse and they went from place to place in search of food. No, that wasn't you. That wasn't your ancestors. We stayed in one place. We built forts. We built wooden houses. We built stone houses. We grew crops. Stop. 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 That's what I'm here for, to teach you your history, to help you to understand that we're a mighty, mighty good people. FBA economic independence has always been thwarted by second frequency. When they see us trying to make some money, when they see us trying to do good, when we put all our business in one spot, they come and destroy those businesses. But just think, listen to me. You know, when my sons was over this past Sunday and we were looking at my Chicago Bears, yes, I like the Chicago Bears. I'm a Bear fan. And like I was telling my sons, I said, fellas, I said, just think if maybe 20 of those millionaires sitting on that bench, 20 of those millionaire football players, 5 of those basketball players, just think if they bought one franchise, McDonald's or some of the other franchises out there, you know, just think they could, in the sense that they just bought one of those and they put that in their hometown and they put one in the city where they play. Know what they could do? They could put at least 60 to 120 people to work. They could be building up the community. And then the European, he couldn't just come and say, oh, we got to stop these Negroes, in a sense, from sticking together, making money. They wouldn't even know what you were doing, because what you're doing is that you're developing an economic plan that they wouldn't even see through. But you're putting your people to work. Stop it. Stop it. We need to talk to our athletes. Instead of our athletes just always having these baby mamas that take all their money, they could, in a sense, have a McDonald's or have a Kentucky Fried or have some of those other franchises and put your people to work. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. We have to economically develop our communities. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. Stop saying in a sense that every black person has to be unified before we can get progress. That's a damn lie.
Teach, teach.
All white people, they're not unified, and they make and they produce stuff. We don't have to be unified either. But what we need is some concerned people, some people that want to make businesses, some people that want to put us to work, put my people to work, give them some jobs. Stop thinking that that the European can see everything you do. Give them some jobs. Get those kids some jobs. Get some of those young people, old people, jobs. And we can do this. We can do this. We already built all the technology in this country. We built in a sense. We made the telephone work, the electric light bulb. We made the chips. We made the chips. Now they got to get chips from overseas. We invented the damn microchip. We invented all of that stuff.
Michelle, you need to quit. You need to quit with the Pookies and the Ray Rays. You ain't right.
That's right. Stop with the Pookies and the Ray Rays. They okay, but just look at this old Kyrie Irving thing. Look at this thing is that they get mad. They get mad at Chappelle. And all Chappelle said was that when he goes to Hollywood, he sees a lot of Jews.
That's all he said.
That don't mean the Jews run the entertainment industry. But just think, they got mad at him for saying that. But what about them letting all these rappers talk about always, you know, just seeing sisters at a damn bar dancing with somebody saying, oh, you perform oral sex on me and all that type of stuff. You got a penis in your mouth. Just think about that. Why are you dancing to stuff like that? Why you accept it?
Come on, Pop.
Why you
accept Educate it? Us. Come on.
You accepting this stuff in a sense that's really to destroy us. Stuff to bring us down. We had to stop it. We had to stop it. We have
got to do better for them.
That just like they don't like people to say negative things about them, we shouldn't allow our rappers, these other people, to just carry on this diabolical plan. This diabolical plan. They bought up all the distribution companies. They bought up all the black record companies. They bought up all the damn musical companies so they can teach us this trash. To teach
Absolutely.
Us to hate ourselves. To teach Absolutely. Us to want to bring each other down.
To kill each other.
Most of all.
It's a CIA operation. It's a psyops.
Most of all. They want to teach us not to love our women. We need our women. Sister.
We need
I
you.
I love you. I need you. Let's stop these people from telling my man that we love our women. Stop it. Stop.
Come on, Clyde. Come on now.
Stop it. Aboriginal FBA adopted Mongoloid Indians and second frequency gave them our heritage. Yes. Blackfeet. The Blackfeet Indians is a beautiful picture of a Blackfoot Indian living in Virginia and North Carolina. Oh, now it's Blackfeet Indians. Now it's Blackfeet Indians out in the Midwest. Wasn't no Blackfeet Indians out there. Oh, yeah, that's right. The white man said, you are Mongoloid Indians and you white folk. Y'all go out there and pretend y'all Blackfeet. We'll give you the black people heritage. They still are heritage every day. But I know the truth. And I'm going to teach you the truth. I'm going to teach you our true history. Over the last year, I wrote over at least 50 different PDFs to go with all of my programs. You can find all the PDFs for the podcast between 2021 and 22 and the 2-volume Black History Gems essays. And here you can find all of the PDFs. Get that information, get that knowledge. I also have, in a sense, a program. And in this program, I have a curriculum so that you can use those to have your kids learn at home. You know, one day, we'll probably, or we may do a class where we're going to invite parents to learn how to homeschool their kids. A lot of parents want to teach their kids history. And I'm going to give a lot of parents some advice on how they can teach their kids history. It'll probably be a 4-week program. We'll probably set that up soon. And what we're going to do is that I'm going
Fantastic.
To help parents to understand how to teach your kids history, how to have your kids, in a sense, understand what to do, you know. And this is what we need. We need our kids to understand their history. And these books can help our kids to learn these history, just like these videos. We are not here. We're not coming here every Thursday just to entertain. No. No. We're coming here every Thursday to help you, to give you information, to help you expand your horizons, and also to help our children, the children, the children, the children, the children. We need them to know who they are and what they can become. And the only way they can do that is to have an understanding of their history. They had a video this week where this teacher told these black kids that I'm white and I'm superior to you. And those boys, I was surprised that they spoke up and said, you know, you're racist. And he said, okay, I'm racist. And they fired him, but they didn't fire him right away because they want our kids to grow up feeling that they're superior. That's what they did in Wakanda. Wakanda forever.
Mm-hmm.
Wakanda forever. These people are supposed to be the most advanced technologically people, and yet we find out that the white man, the CIA and FBI is listening to all their broadcasts, listening to their communications. How could they do that? But that's just to let you know. In Wakanda forever, that was just to let you know that the white man always sees you. That second frequency knows what you're doing. And that second frequency will get you if you don't watch out. This Saturday, I'm going to do a presentation on the Song Productions. In this presentation, I'm going to talk with Dr. Keftufasa about the Hyksos. I'm going to explain how they were really Kushites. And we're going to have a scholarly discourse. So you may want to sign up. You can go to https://www.saankproductions.com/events. Sign up. You're going to enjoy this program. It's going to be very informative. And you're going to get information that you can only get there. You know, I want you to sign up. There's a nominal cost. But the point is that research, you have to understand, sometimes in a sense you can get more done with research, but some things have to be financed, you know. A lot of people think that you can just do this research on your own. Much of my research I financed myself. That means, in a sense, can you imagine the thousands of dollars I had to spend to produce 37 books, 38, whatever the number of the damn books, I don't know. But anyway, can you imagine how much money I had to do that? When you look at Sister Marie Childs and all of that work, look at her room. When she does a presentation, her room shows all these posts, all these papers, all these files. That's money that we had to spend to try to do the research to bring to you, family. This costs money. That's why I appreciate so much my Patreon people, because my Patreon people, they sincerely want me to be able to do this job, and they sincerely want me to be able to do a good job every week. And I'm able to do that because I'm being supported. You don't know what it means. You don't know what it means to have people out there, family, who love you. People out there that don't mind supporting you. You know, sometimes they give me good messages. That a boy. I'm not a boy, but that a boy. But I mean, it's like a pat on the back. I need that. I don't have my wife anymore. My wife, when she's alive, she could pat me on the head. Yeah, okay, Clyde, you can do it. But now I need you, family. I need you, family. And when you join my Patreon, that lets me know that I'm not by myself. That lets me know that there's people out there that want to know the truth. That lets me know that there's people out there that want to, in a sense, find out the truth, and I'm going to do it.
Well, let's start with, why are you saying that Wakanda Forever promotes white supremacy?
I hate to say this. You see, Wakanda promotes white supremacy. Look, here's an advertisement. Here we see Suri, some of the other people in the film. Then we see Namor, and then we see M'Baka, the strongest Negro in the whole film. And they kick his ass in a minute. President Biden, listen now, listen. On December 8th, 2020, President Biden told civil rights leaders, and I quote, this is just think you're listening to Jim Crow Biden. By 2040, this country is going to be minority white European, Biden said. You hear me? Minority white Europeans. White folks don't like hearing that. You guys are going to have to start working more with Hispanics, who make up a larger portion of the population than y'all all do, Biden said. Listen to that. Listen to that. This man promised us a lot of stuff and he gave us nothing. Right now they're in the Senate about to make a marriage law to protect the rights of gay people to marry each other. Yet he didn't fulfill making a trade association for us. He didn't
build
a commission to protect us from police brutality.
That's
yet
right.
He's doing this. He claims he can't do it. But this man has the nerve to tell you that you have to listen to the Hispanics.
Ain't that something? Divide and conquer strategies right there in your face.
Not only that, but it explains why we have Wakanda forever.
Come on.
It implies that the only hope for FBA is submission to Latinos in a black and brown coalition. This statement implies that sadly a black and brown coalition is impossible. Yes, it's impossible. It's impossible because Latin people, except for some Puerto Ricans, usually support white supremacy and Republicans who support anti-black issues. The Washington Post observed that the two groups have different views on whether racism exists. Yes, yes, yes. You know, it was only up until the 1970s. Before that, Mexicans would put on their census forms that they were white. White, yes, white. They only went around with that brown stuff and now trying to say they're a minority so they could take money away from us that was delegated for the black people, the minority people. So they stopped calling themselves whites so they could get a little cash. I was working at I was teaching at Cook County Jail in Division One. I used to work for the Safer Foundation. And so it was two Indians there. One of the Indians, they were, you know, I got along with them. They were really nice brothers. Then one day Matthew came in. He said, Clyde. I said, well, what's up? He said, look at this letter. And in the letter, this bank was offering him $65,000 to start a business in the 90s. He said he didn't even ask for the money. But that's just to show you how this country
brings
over here, and they're giving them money. The banks are ready to lend them money. The banks are ready to give them money. You find more poor ass Latinos over here with businesses. You go to the Latino community, they got businesses all over the place. You know, and you go down to Mexico, you only see the white Mexicans with all the damn businesses. You only see the only brown Mexicans you see in Mexico, they be selling stuff from a little food cart. I didn't say a food truck, I said a food cart. But they have many businesses over here because they give these immigrants money. They give these immigrants loans, you see? But they don't want to give you a loan. They've done studies. They sent black people and Latino people to buy a house, and the bank will get a Latino people a loan, and they won't get a black person loan. They do that to keep you down. They keep you down. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. You can't have a black and brown coalition. Because they already have set it up so that the brown gonna get it. You get nothing. And in October
14th,
from the Washington Post, Claudia Sandoval and Shia Crowder wrote that this week a recording of Latino, you probably remember this happened just a few weeks ago. This week a recording of Latino Los Angeles City Council members making racist comments burst into the news. But Latino anti-black racism is not new or surprising. I'm not saying this. This is from the Washington Post. This was written by Claudia Sandoval and Shia Crowder. They said, but Latino anti-black racism is not new or surprising. A number of scholars have examined the conflict between these two groups. Yes, yes, yes. As you can see, the conflicts between black and brown groups is not a new phenomenon. For example, there's anti-Latino immigrant rhetoric by the Republican Party overall. Even though the Republican Party is against immigrants, the Latinos still prefer Republican candidates, not FBA. Look at the Biden administration. He ain't got rid of every FBA except for the defense secretary. And in a sense, the person in the United Nations, all the other department heads that really give out money and grants, they're all headed by Latinos. But it was more FBA voted for Biden than Latinos. But he's giving Latinos benefits.
Facts.
He's giving Latinos, money. He's giving them jobs. He's giving them tangibles. All they give us is a lot of BS. Stop. These people, they let them come over here. They let them come into the country. And then instead of these immigrants who they let in here illegal, they go vote Republican. Yet these Democrats, they put them all throughout our cities, all throughout our towns, all throughout wherever there's a lot of black people. They put the Spanish in hoping they can replace us. Nobody can replace us.
Say FBA. It. Say it, baby.
Wait, baby, FBA. You know, Latinos still prefer Republican candidates, not FBA. This was made clear in the 2022 Georgia election, in which Latinos voted overwhelmingly for the incumbent Republican Governor Brian Kemp instead of Democratic candidate Stacey Abrams. Stacey Abrams out there kissing ass. Stacey Abrams out there, she wouldn't even say she was going to give black people nothing. We asked her, what about reparations? She said, bro, she said, nigga, what? I said, damn, you're not from Chicago. But she still said, nigga, what? You think I'm crazy? Politico noted that, and I quote, both parties heavily pursued Hispanic voters, blowing past old records on Spanish language, ad buys, and holding more frequent events courting Latino voters. After those campaign efforts, Hispanics saw the second biggest shift among voters of color, with Democrats' overall margins dropping 9 points since 2018, yes, and 21 points specifically among Latino men. Compared to 2020, the Democratic margin among Latinos decreased by 5 points. This woman is so stupid. This woman is so stupid, and I don't like to say this, but the New York Times, they did an evaluation on her campaign. They found out that these black businessmen asked her to go and talk to some black businessmen to try to get some support. They told her to go talk to the fraternities and sororities. Yeah, we'll admit that that Kamala Harris had that support. But the thing is, do you think she went to talk to those black businessmen? No. Do you think she went to talk to the fraternities and the sororities? No. What she wanted to do was talk about abortion. Damn. We're very conservative. Not that we don't get abortions, but every black person, that's not our main concern. Our main concern is getting a job. Our main concern
facts,
is getting tangible.
Facts.
Our main concern
economics,
is
economic empowerment.
For the check. You see, but she's
yes,
going
sir.
Around, and then what happened? Whereas Stacey Abrams wouldn't go talk to the black business, you know what Kim did? Brian Kemp, he went and had a champagne party with the brothers. Why? Why don't you do the basic thing? Our so-called black candidates, they don't understand your basis, black people. White people aren't going to hardly vote for you. Latinos aren't going to hardly vote for you. Asians ain't going to hardly vote for you. Focus on your base. The Republicans always focus on their base. But what do we do? What do we do? We always want to follow the Democrats, and that's why she lost, and that's why Warnock. If Warnock don't get out there and start talking some real stuff, he's not going to be reelected. He lost in a debate with Herschel Walker. Because Herschel Walker was talking plain language. This man talking about, we got to get abortion. We got to do this. You dummy, you're going to lose. You're going to lose. You're going to lose. Go for your people, you dumbass.
Come on, Doc. So you're about a Latino black divide, but what does that have to do with Wakanda Forever?
Damn, what does that have to do with Wakanda Forever? What does that have to do with Wakanda Forever? That's a good question. Let's look at it this way. The bias in favor of Latinos espoused by President Biden was also evident in Wakanda Forever, yes. Yes, Biden told those black leaders, those civil rights leaders, they better kiss some Latino ass. Texas.
That he did.
Wakanda Forever was Latinos supposed, you're supposed to kiss their asses. Here's this man, Namor. I got to get y'all. Namor. He comes into Wakanda. Then the queen and Suri, the princess, they ask, how you getting here, boss? They didn't say boss, but I'm just saying that. How you getting here, boss? And they had their eyes all popped. Yaza! Yeah, how you even get in here? Me, I got in here because I am Namor. You women, you better not tell nobody I talk to you. If you tell somebody I talk to you, I will come back and kick your little skinny asses. Now listen. Come on now. I don't know how many of y'all have looked at Marvel. I look at Marvel movies all the time. These people fought in the Infinity Wars, even Suri. Suri fought in the Infinity Wars.
Sure did.
She fought against Thanos.
Yep.
And you mean you can't stop somebody with feathers on their feet?
Feathers on their feet.
You can't stop somebody that just swam under the water? You don't have no defenses for underwater? Get out of here. But they told you that because they want you. What did Biden tell you? Jim Crow Joe, he told you, you better let those Mexicans run your ass because you stupid. You stupid.
Mm-hmm.
You stupid.
Real talk. That's what he did. That's what he did. And I bet you that's what they're going to do.
That's what Namor did. Namor. Mm-hmm. Namor. They don't even know how he got into their country. Wakanda Forever is a film about the events in Wakanda after the death of Black Panther. It is a time in which foreign powers believe that without Black Panther, Wakanda can be overrun by neighboring states. A new power like Atlantis called Talokan appears on the scene and wants to force Wakanda to fight with them and take over the world. Wakandians refuse, and Wakanda is flooded, and the queen is murdered. Yes, the queen is murdered right in front of Suri's face.
And they did nothing.
Nothing. The rest of the film explains how the Wakandians regroup and defeat the Talokan. During the film, we see many scenes in which Wakandians are humbled by the minds of Talokan. For example, the best warrior in Wakanda, Okoye, and the strongest man in Wakanda, second only to Black Panther, the tribal elder, M'Baku, are both easily defeated by the Talokan. Yes, yes, yes! Listen. Now, you think about this. The Talokan, they live under the water, right? That means if I fought you under the water, you might kick my ass. But you're going to tell me some damn people going to come on land and beat you? And you ain't fought in the Infinity Wars? You ain't fought against the best alien troops with high, in a sense, technology. You ain't fought them, and then some blue people from under the water going to kick your ass. Come on now.
Yeah, basically, Avatar whooped your ass. Basically, that's what it is. They blue people. That's Avatar whooped our ass. Come on, that don't make no damn sense. Those blue people.
But they did it right because let's go back to what Biden said to them. Yo, Negroes. He not country, but I'm gonna talk in the way he really think. Yo, Negroes, we gonna lose the country in 40 years. You better let them Hispanics tell your black ass what to do. Get out of here. Get out of here. Look at this big, strong, you know, M'Baku. Look at this brother. Man, he's stronger. He was only second to Black Panther. And then Namor. Hit him and broke his damn chest plate. And then that nigga got, I'm sorry, that Negro, he got his eyes all bucking. What was that now? Y'all's a ball.
You ain't right. You ain't right.
Them Latinos, they kick our ass.
You ain't right.
Get out of here.
Love it, Doc.
In the last scene, we do see Black Panther, T'Challa's genius, scientist sister Shuri defeat the Talokan leader, Namor. She makes fire and she burns his back. and he's up from underwater. So she does something to burn his back, and then she gets over him. And she's got a spear. And she's standing over this man. She saw this man kill her mother mercilessly in front of her face, and yet she has the spear, and she can stab him in the damn heart. But they made it like those black people you see on TV after their relatives be killed by another white person. Yazabaz, I'm going to pray. Oh, Jesus, take your God in Jesus.
That's what they do.
They never ask white people when their kids get killed. They don't ask them to forgive them. That black man who ran into that parade and killed those old people who was out there parading in Wisconsin, they gave him 750 years.
762
years. She said, the judge said, that's excessive. Damn, that's more than excessive. You could have just gave him a natural life term. But no, she wanted to teach you Negroes. I'm a foundational Black American, but she wanted to teach you Negroes what happened to you if you dare get into the clutches of white supremacists. And that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. Now look, look at this picture. Look at this picture. You can see, here's a picture. In another scene, we see the Wakanda warriors hemmed up in a small corner of the Wakandian ship. They're on a ship, not mind you. They're on a ship on land. They're not in the water. And look at all these Latinos about to push them off the ship, about to kill these black people. You know, the telecon about to kill the best warriors on the planet Earth. They ain't for the aliens. They ain't for superior. These people only got spears. They don't even have no guns.
Bring it.
They don't even have any laser pistols. You know,
bring the logic.
She was fighting in the Infinity Wars. She put on that little mitten and be shooting out shit.
Yep. Yep. You know?
And yet, you want me to believe. You want me to believe that these people who live under the ocean, all they got is spears. You want me to believe that they can beat the Wakandans? You want me to believe that they can beat the Wakandans? But you have to believe they can beat the Wakandans, because remember what Jim Crow Joe told you. You're going to have to let those Hispanics know, yo, Negro ass, what to do.
Come on.
Psychology. To make you feel that you're helpless, to make you feel you're homeless. If the best warriors in Wakanda can't be some people with spears who blew, then there's no
and that is psychological operations. What you said earlier is about, this is about the children. See that, you see, now we are adults, we might be able to figure this out, but what is the message? How are the children taking this? That's who they're going after. They're going after that generation, that new voter generation that's coming up.
That's right. They want them to feel that they had to do what Daddy Biden told him. Daddy Biden told him. Biden told you that y'all Negroes can't do nothing by y'all self. Y'all had to let the Hispanics tell you what to do.
Right. See?
And that's why Namor. And then these people about to kill all the top Wakandan warriors. But then Namor says, stop. Do not kill these people, even though we're about to F them up. Stop.
Right. That's exactly right.
The best warriors in the world about to look at they're on the edge of the damn ship.
Yep.
And you're taking your kids to see this junk. You're taking your kids to go see a movie that tells them that they can't do nothing because they're black. And yet these Latinos can kick your ass. Get out of here. Get out of here.
That's right. Come on, Doc.
In Wakanda forever. Granted, Shuri defeats Namor. But the theme of the movie is that the Wakandans cannot beat the Mayans of Telucan. This theme matches perfectly President Biden's demand that FBA submit to Latino guidance and supremacy. It is obvious from these scenes of the Telucans subjugating the Wakandians that the aim of this film was to imply that blacks cannot make progress on their own, as advocated by President Biden. Don't you see? This is a psyops.
This is psychological operations, family. This is social engineering. Yeah, let's get back, let me hold your PowerPoint for a second. Anita, I want to put Anita W. up here. She says, Dr. Winters, I wish I had heard this lecture before I saw the movie. I agree, capital letters, with everything that you said. It's important, fam, that you have elders, scholars in the community that can break down this understanding and what Dr. Winters talked about last week, making visible the invisible, because even I didn't see everything, but because we're part of this community and there's people I can pick up a phone or text and call and say, what did you think? Now you get all of the full information. So yesterday we talked about the sacred aspect of it and the frequency aspect of it. And that was necessary and needed. That's what we need to do. That's part of the culture that we need to do to get out of this situation. But here you need to see the political operation of a blockbuster movie, because every blockbuster movie, not even, they don't even have to be blockbuster, but every movie, particularly from Hollywood, the ones that are really what we call a franchise, all of that has a hidden agenda. And one of my former attorneys, who was an Army vet, was a consultant on a lot of movies. And he said, they hire me as a consultant to come in and put in tactical, practical operations for the agenda of what, you know, keeps America, quote unquote, great again, and keeps America white. So this is not just entertainment, but the way to educate and train a community is to keep putting propaganda in front of you, to the point where you no longer see the propaganda. You just see it as entertainment. And then you start subconsciously believing, not only can you not defeat these people, but what's the point of voting anyway? What's the point of showing up anyway? What's the point of showing my black power and my B1 power anyway? That's the psychological underpinnings of what's going on here. And see, and thank you for that, Anita.
They knew that everybody's going to say, oh, yeah, this is, well, I expect them to be doing the feminine, making the men look effeminate. I expect them to make the women look all masculine. But see, they didn't expect me to see that they were also trying to carry out President Biden's
agenda.
And his agenda is to make you feel that you're inferior to Hispanic people, to make feel you're inferior to Latino people, to make you feel that you cannot do anything. Yeah, they let Suri beat him, but at the same time, they showed you that if Namor had not came and told them to stop, they would have killed her whole army. That was her army. Those were her troops.
That was the message.
See, and that was the message to your children. The message to your children is stop, Negroes. I'm FBI. Mm-hmm. Stop, you Negroes, feeling that you can be independent. Stop, you Negroes.
And before we even end the show with the comments, because I know some of y'all going to come on. As not my core group, but some of the people gonna come out and say, it was just a movie. Y'all just trying to read in too deep. It's still just a movie, family. Grow up. You know, when I hear stupid people like that, I see what assimilation looks like. Hey. Right? Assimilation is when you fight for your own oppression.
Stop.
That's assimilation.
That's not assimilation. I'm sorry.
Okay, go for it.
Assimilation means. I'm sorry to interrupt you,
Dr. No, no worries. No worries.
But the thing is, assimilation means to pull you into another society, to allow you to assimilate. They never allow black people to assimilate. They allow us to associate. We can associate.
Ooh.
They don't assimilate us.
They'll
allow us to be around.
I like that, Doc. Yes.
They'll allow us to get their black, get some white-itis, get between those white thighs.
Nice,
they'll allow her a zaddy and feel every time that she's having intercourse with him that she's dominating the white man because she's making the white man come so fast.
I'm going to rewrite that section of my book. Association. That's genius. Thank you, Elder. Thank you. Let's keep going. This was good stuff.
As a result, Wakanda Forever is following the usual white supremacist tenets. and they must allow other people to guide them. Yes, they feel that Black people, we need guidance. They feel that we can't do anything on our own. They feel in the sense that now that we dare, listen, you better understand what they did. They destroyed Wakanda. They destroyed Wakanda. The minute they let Namor come into Wakanda and they couldn't stop him, that showed in a sense that we have no safety, we have no security. And if, right. And if the smartest Black people on the planet Earth in Wakanda could not stop this man from getting into their country, that's telling you to feel insecure. Look at the right. PSYOPs. Look at the PSYOPs.
Right. Psychological operations.
You guys thought you were going to a movie to celebrate Wakanda. You guys thought you were going to a movie to celebrate the life of T'Challa. No. You were going to a movie to teach you that you ain't ish. To teach you can't do nothing without them.
I'm going to put this on the screen.
No.
I'm going to put this on the screen. Yes.
Somebody.
I like this. I like Brother Akil, who gives me my nickname, the Uncle Phil of Philosophy. I love this. The mental holocaust continues. I love that. That is exactly what it
is. When did it ever stop?
True that. True that. That's good stuff. Thank you, Akil.
And they destroyed Wakanda because they took away our sanctuary.
Yep. I mean, come on, Doc. They come into you just like white supremacy. They come into your home, they take over your land, they kill all of the indigenous people, they kill the queen.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna forgive you and I'm gonna let you live. You gotta be out of your goodness.
And they're about to kill your key warriors, and it takes
no
more.
Right.
Get out of here.
Say his name one more time, Doc.
Namor.
Okay.
Not Namor. Namor. You got to make the R roll.
You got to get that R up in there. Yeah, you got to put that R in there a few times. Mm-hmm.
Roll it, baby.
Oh, as the country people would say, Namara.
Namor.
Keep going, Doc. Come on. This is good teaching.
The case of Stacey Abrams' run for governor indicates that Latinos do not support FVA. They don't support us. It was obvious in the voting patterns of Latinos during the midterm elections of 2022 that any idea of Black and brown coalition is a one-sided idea only practiced by FVA. Yes, we're the only ones that want to be, really, in a sense, have a coalition. They don't want to have a coalition. They want to replace you, FVA. But nobody can replace us. Nobody can replace us.
We don't die. We multiply, baby.
But it's really about 140 million Black FBA people in this country. I'll say it again, 140
million. If not more than that,
if not more. But the whole absolutely. Point is they want you to feel you're a minority. But look, you know you're more than what they say you are. Because look, when Obama was running for president, We even took Georgia, a lot of other places. Why? Because we came out to vote. We thought he was FBA brother, and we thought he was going to try to help us get some rights. And he put a foot up our ass. Yeah,
pretty much.
Obama put a foot up our ass because he wasn't FBA.
Mm-hmm.
FBA, you got no allies. Black people all over the world, listen to me. You can be in Africa. You can be in London. But you have no allies. Nobody's with you. So you better bring your own with you.
That's right.
Bring your own. Make it known.
Bring your killmonger with you. Bring your ancestral killmonger with you.
Look, and even in the first movie, they wanted to make you feel that Black power was wrong. Subliminal insemination.
Right. So are there examples of earlier attempts to make Black and brown coalitions?
Yes, it is.
Beloved Doc?
Yes, it is. This begs the question. Is there any historical evidence that suggests that Black and brown people can truly work together politically? The historical evidence makes it clear that there has never been a true Black and brown coalition because the Browns, Latinos, fear that unifying with blacks will lead to their genetic annihilation through mixing of the two races. Yes, 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 yes. Do you know the most important weapon that a black man has? Is his penis and his semen.
Genetic material.
Genetic material. That penis. It's like a machine gun, baby.
You ain't got no damn sense. Walk away, Clyde. Walk away. Walk. Let it go. Let it go. Walk away. You worse than what was our beloved comedian who bang, 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 bang. That's Clyde. That's that generation. Go ahead. Keep teaching, you crazy man.
Historical examples of possible black and brown relations come from Mexico. It was in Mexico that black and brown people were in contact with each other for thousands of years. There was a connection between the Mayas. These people are considered to be the original Mayas. Do they look mongoloid to you? Hell no.
Nope.
These were the pre-classic Maya. These people were in Mexico even before, in a sense, the Olmec got there, because the Olmec came from Africa. Jaguar pyramids and inscriptions. The Olmec taught the Maya architecture and all the related sciences. Moreover, throughout Maya history, they depicted in its monuments and art, we see the presence of Africans. Yes, yes, yes. They tried to teach us for years that it wasn't any black Mayans. But because of the internet, then black people could put the pictures, they could go in the library, they could get the books, and they could show how the Mayas. Many of them really looked. They weren't known mongoloid. They found that the site of Okos illustrates that the earliest Maya were Africans. Yes, Africans. Or black people, at least. They used a ceramic type at Okos that was used by other African communities in Mexico between 1500 and 850 BC. The properties, the presence of Africans in the early Maya sites explain who we are. Mesoamerica is a geographical name for Mexico and the countries of Central America. Today, people believe that the blacks of Mexico and the blacks of Guatemala, Honduras, and Belize are descendants of sub-Saharan African slaves taken to Mexico during the Atlantic slave trade. This is false. Yes, yes. You black people in Guatemala, Honduras, Belize, many of your ancestors go back thousands of years. Your ancestors weren't all slaves, but that's what the European teaches you. That's what second frequency teaches you, to make you feel that you can be a minority. Look at how they took away Wakanda from us. They took away the greatest black civilization that never existed in the fictional world.
Right.
And let the Hispanics come and take it over. Why? Can't you let us have something? The black native Mesoamericans, B&M, live in an area from Eastern Chiapas in Mexico into much of Guatemala, Belize, and West Honduras. These black native Mesoamericans were influenced by the African Olmecs, who lived in the Gulf region of Mexico. Olmec sites in these areas are called colonial Olmec. During the pre-classic period, the Maya, with assistance from African Mexicans, developed mathematics, non-telescopic astronomy, and calendrical calculation more advanced than any other Mesoamerican civilization except for the Olmecs. Do you know, let me tell you something, family. Do you know that the calendar that they use in among the Mayas, that was invented by black people? Yes, we gave them the calendar. We gave them the mathematics. We gave them the zero.
That's right.
But they teach you that you can't do math. They tell your children they're dumb. They tell you that your kids aren't worth nothing. They tell you we're going to put your kid in special education because they can't learn a damn thing. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. But they don't want your kids to be competitive. They don't want your kids to know who they are. They don't want your kid to be a bot. Hey, oh! The Maya homeland extended throughout the whole of the Yucatan Peninsula, parts of Guatemala, right into the Cordillera of Belize in San Salvador. The Maya cities, Copan, Tikal, and Pitan, had thousands of inhabitants and were built on the foundations first constructed by the Olmecs and other African groups. Settled in Mexico when the Maya arrived, yes. Yes, yes. There were black and mongoloid Mayan tribes. You didn't know this before the 2000s. They never showed you the Black Maya.
Mm-hmm. There it is.
S. Moore in 1929, in an article called Bone Change and Sickle Cell Anemia and a Note on Sylvia Chain, he observed that many of the skulls of ancient Mayan Indians showed that they had sickle cell anemia. Who has sickle cell anemia? Black people. We have sickle cell anemia, you see? But they want to tell you that it wasn't any Black Maya. That's so they can steal our heritage. They're always stealing our heritage. That's what they let the Mexicans do in Wakanda. They let the Mexicans take Wakanda. They let some people with spears. Don't even have any flying machines. They had to ride around on whales. They want me to believe that some people with spears, some people who ride on wheels, on whales, they can be people with high technology. They can be people that fought aliens. They have been people who got super weapons, but they beat by some people with spears. No, that's impossible.
It is impossible.
That's for you. Mm-hmm.
That's for
you.
The psyops.
Yes, that's the psyops. That's for your kids to feel they can't do without the help of somebody else. Listen.
Let me say this, because this is really important. I understand how they're presenting this. They're presenting it to you in the name of diversity. Oh, we're a diverse group. We're one country. We're one nation. We're one people. No, we're not. And diversity, DEI community, diversity, equity, and inclusion, really is a joke community. Why? Because it is a community of experts who are supposedly basically promoting AIDS. That's what the diversity, equity, inclusion group does. Now, I had extensive conversations with Resma Minicum, Dr. Jacqueline Battalore, both whom are DEI experts. And I remember Resma using a when he was presenting to a group of whites, and he went in, he asked the question, how many of you believe in diversity? And all of the hands just flew up. You know, people had two hands up because we believe in diversity. And then the next question he asked them was, diverse in what? Or diverse from what? And no hands went up, major confusion. And then it started moving into that white rage and white fragility because they realized, why you are quote unquote the super group. And we've got to be diverse, and as Dr. Winters corrected me, not assimilate, but associate with this group. No, we're not associating with your group because your group is designed to erase us and to kill us. So be careful, fam, when people come to you and say, this film and the reason why we did this is in the name of diversity. Diversity is our genetic annihilation, as well as the Amu's genetic annihilation. Go ahead, Doc.
Girl, look at this. They the film that made the most money ever in the history. I think whatchamacallit's the multiverse made a little bit more, but the film that made the most money in history, the film that had black people really proud of being black to believe that there was a fictional place. Wakanda, that they've let you know now that some Latinos can go to Wakanda and the Wakandans can't do nothing about it. That scene when Namor comes in and meets the queen in Suri, that's an important scene. That's a scene to tell your children, you are weak. You can't do anything. Anybody can still supersede your culture.
They
beat Thanos. They helped defend us.
Right.
They can't be some people with spears. Get out of here.
That's right.
Let's continue. Due to the contributions of Africans to Mesoamerican civilization, Many other Mongoloid Mayan gods were depicted as Africans. The gods in the Mayan Aztec manuscript illustrated blacks include Kukulkan and Akchua. Wait a minute. Let me see. What was the other name of Namor? Oh, yeah. His name was what? Kukulkan. Nigga, what? Kukulkan was black. You see how they stole your history?
Nice.
They made a damn Latino Kukulkan when Kukulkan was black. Like you. Like me. The so-called Mayan leader of Wakanda forever, Namor, or Kukulkan, was black. Yes, black. See how the motion pictures teach you a whitewashed history of where blacks are whited out? They white you out of history.
There it is, right in our faces.
They white you out of history. They don't want you to come here. They don't want your family to be here every Thursday. They don't want you to sit around and listen to me and Reverend Dr. Matthews chop it up. They don't want you to know who you are.
They don't know. They do not want y'all to see this. I know that. I know damn well. They do not want you to see this.
That's right. The god of the African merchants, Maya land, was Ekchuan. Ekchuan appears 17 times in Madrid Codex and once in the Drissen Codex. Ekchuan has affinity to the Olmec bird god of the Kuno cult. Ekchuan is often called the long-nosed god. Got him with his spear and his merchants back. Yes. If they would have had the real Maya, and they would have had the real Kukulkan, not Namor, maybe they would have been. That would have been black people with spears fighting black people with spears. But they are teaching you a lie. Don't you see?
Now, something else, Doc. I want to elucidate, and I want your opinion on this. Now, I mentioned yesterday that I thought it was nice that they put IAT in there, but they did it in a way where they didn't mention anything about the success of IAT defeating white supremacy. They made it a third world country that needed help from whiteness and from this new buffer class. What are your thoughts on that, beloved?
You're absolutely correct. Remember, they had to call the white FBI agent. You see?
Yep. CIA guy. Mm-hmm.
We found out from the white FBI agent, wife or boss or whatever.
Yeah, whatever his name is.
That they're able to tap into all of the Wakandan communications, but Wakanda, they can't tap into their communication. Get out of here.
Exactly.
These people, the Wakandans can fly into space. Wakandans can go to other planets.
Come on.
You see?
Come on.
They wanted to let you know and let your children know that Wakanda is nothing. They wanted you to know that you may have built up the idea that Wakanda is a place where black people have superiority, but nobody is more superior to the second frequency and their tethers.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Blacks were living in Mexico in 1492. These sub-Saharan Africans were trading with the Mongoloid Amerindians. In addition to having their own settlements in the Americas, Amerigo Vespucci met African merchants on their way back to West Africa in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. Yes. Up to 1492, it was still African people sailing all the way from West Africa to trade in the Americas. But the Spanish and the Portuguese, they cut that out. They attacked their ships to steal a gold. Much of what we know about African nautical science comes from Vasco da Gama. Yeah, Vasco da Gama is said to have found information about the West Indies from Ahmed B. Majid, a navigator he met during his travels along the west coast of Africa. Yes, da Gama claimed that Ibn Majid wrote a handbook of navigation on the Indian Ocean, the Red Sea, and the Persian Gulf. Yes. You didn't know that, Doc. When Columbus came here, Columbus had maps. He had maps from the West Africans. He had maps from the Moors. Remember, Vasco da Gama and the rest of those Portuguese, they went up and down the West African coast before they came to America. That's why, in a sense, the Portuguese, they didn't want Mexico. They wanted Brazil. And they went to the Pope. And I said, Paul, give us Brazil. Let those Spanish fools have Mexico. Learn your history. Learn your history.
Come on, Doc. Love this. The Spanish
left us mention of many sub-Saharan communities in Central America. These dark-skinned Mayans were Africans, not Mongoloid Indians. Paul Gaffarel noted that when Balboa reached America, he found Nicodé Veritables, or true blacks. Look. Balboa noted, and I quote, Indian traditions of Mexico and Central America indicate that Negroes were among the first occupants of that territory. This is why so many Mexicans have African faces. They like to put on the internet and they say, oh no, these Mexicans, these are the real Olmecs. They're not the real Olmecs. They just been mixed with black people because we was the damn rulers over here. They mixed with black people because they mamas and grandmamas got gunned down by that black penis. And it went,
there he goes again. I can't control myself. There it goes again. No! Just let it go. Walk away, Pop. Let it go.
I'm going. There have been many black Mexican civilizations in Mexico, especially the black Maya. Look at these brothers and look at these black Mayas. Look at them hats. That's not made up ish. How many of y'all saw those rappers wearing hats like these? Look. It's nothing new, baby. Remember?
Been here, done that.
That's right. Knowing is winning. When you know the truth.
Yes.
The Guadalupe Pyramid. This is what they believe it was. They believe this pyramid was red. You know, inside of the pyramid, they have a picture of the king. And his name is Tali. He is the dignitary buried in the San Bartolo Pyramid. Look at Tali. Look at the brother had a little beard there. Yes, sir. And he had hair. I'm jealous. He got hair. I lost my hair.
It's all right. It's on the ancestral realm waiting for you.
Oh, okay.
Now I feel happy. You'll see your hair again as well as I. I'm talking all kind of ish. I'm saying the same thing for myself. Yeah.
I feel happy. I'm going to get my hair. Ancestors, protect my hair.
I'll have my afro in Wakanda. I'll have my afro back in
happy
Wakanda.
Happy Olmec tomb scene in San Bartolo. These are some of the figures of San Bartolo. They don't show you these figures. They want to always show you Mongoloids. They always want to make you think that the Maya wasn't black. Yes, it was some Mongoloid Indians, but they came later. Here's a very beautiful mural from the San Bartolo mural. If you read from right to left, we have Leota. Indeed, the vivid image of the race here. See, that's at the end. And then when we get on that boat, at the beginning of the boat, we see an inscription is read from top to bottom. Lai Tali, Ku Fe Ta Fe. This artisan, Thou Tali, the governor desires to be made sacred and breathing. Yes. Read that ish.
Come on now.
They tell you that you can't read Mayan. You can read Mayan. They use the same damn writing system that the Mandi used. Just because the white man can't read it, he'll read it when I die. When I'm dead, now we can read it. A researcher named Clyde Winters, they probably make a picture of me looking like Michael Jackson. They'll make a picture of me looking like Michael Jackson. This man invented, it won't be a picture of me. This is Clyde Winters.
Oh, that's. You'll have your hair back at least if you're going to look like Michael Jackson. You get a little curl going down the forehead.
Yes, sir.
You know? Yes, sir. Oh, yes, that's sir. Hilarious. You're right. Man. They're going to whiten you up. They're going to lighten you up. That's for sure. That's what they do. That's what they do.
And then they're going to grab somebody and they're going to say he's the one who really made it better. Anyway, we see some other signs in front of another mine with things carried on the head. It says, Tagebe Kufa, preserve the mystic order. The governor and the mystic order are one. Here's the real Azul temple. These are the inscriptions under the real Azul temple. See, they have some other mongoloids maybe outside, but this is what's the tomb. And the name of this king in this tomb is called Ki. See, and here I show you how I break down the hieroglyphics. On the right hand side, you can see a picture that they made of Ki. And this particular conglomeration. These are a mixture of various Mayan signs, and we read Pekilande Luni Betu. And it says the infinite key, that's the king, key, he's the king, has gone to bed. A symbol here, the ruler's soul and Ba in this place of rest. Ba, ba, ba. We read about the Ba in Egyptian.
Incredible.
We're everywhere. Where?
Yes.
You. That's where I wrote my books on the Olmec language. That's where I wrote my books explaining how the first writing systems came from Africa. Please, let your sons, your daughters read those books. Maybe one of them brothers, maybe one of them little kids will take my book and they'll get ahead of me. I'm not afraid. I don't mind, family. I don't mind you doing research to make my research even better. And you can make research yourself. Where's one?
Incredible. Really good stuff, Doc.
Here's the rest of the inscriptions.
Break down the linguistics for us.
It's right there. It's in some of my articles. I wrote in a fantastic article where I discussed that the Mayan language. One day I'll talk about it in place, but not now. Here's some of the other signs where I break down these signs. Yes. The ancestors are talking to you. The ancestors say, black people, don't be afraid. Black people, you can do it. The name of the king in the real Zulu tomb is Ki. Above is an inscription describing this personage as sacred. Kibota Tuku. Ki's ghost is a sacred object. This abode is its possession. Yes. That pyramid at Tiko. That's his pyramid.
So Doc, what were the results of the early attempts at a Black-Brown coalition?
I'm sorry to say they didn't work out just like they don't work out today. The Black Mayans tried to have a coalition with the Brown Mayan Mongoloid Indians due to the richness of Black Mayan civilization. But the Mongoloid Indians became jealous of the Blacks because of their creativity. Yes, they're jealous of us because of our creativity. And eventually engaged in warfare to try to steal the Black civilizational elements to make them their own. Yes. We let these people come around us. We treat them nice. We give them a place to stay. We say, hey, you broke down ass people. You can't do shit on your own. We're going to help you. And what do they do? They always pay us back with a foot up our ass. Although the Black Mexicans and Mongoloids, as illustrated by the Monte Alban Stelas, Blacks were often engaged in wars, continued to build great empires, as illustrated by the Black Mayan Aztecs. Here's a place called Monte Alban. This is the Monte Alban Center. This place was built by Black people. But there are 300 dams and T's, bas reliefs at Monte Alban. And this is situated in the Oaxaca Valley. But when you go and you see these pictures of these Black people, their penises are all sliced. Yeah, they slit those penises. You thought I was just joking when I said that brown people feels that we, in a sense, have a potent weapon, and that's our penis. And they go, pow, pow, pow,
pow, pow. There he goes again. There he goes again. He's out. He's loose. So here you can see the genetic annihilation. You can see the hatred. Whenever they attack your penis, that's when it's dealing with genetic annihilation, not just the size of it, but what the genetic materials can do.
And look how they focused on that. And that was just to let people know what they got to do to keep us down. That was a black and brown representative. Here's a better picture of it. Look at his penis. They hated that. Blacks and Mongoloid Indians were incompetent because brown people always felt that they would be absorbed by the blacks.
Nice.
That's because they penis might go pa 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 pa.
There he is again. He's out again. They keep getting loose. I don't know why. We got to get him back in the cage. Got to get him back.
Some black Mexican Indian traditions were destroyed by Mongoloids, but blacks fought back. Here we see, in a sense, the Monte Alvin. Here's some more pictures. They got 300 pictures of these black men who penises they kind of split fast. And so when the Aztecs came, they had a black and brown coalition, but they had to do what? They had always kicked those brown people ass. I'm not advocating racism. I'm not advocating always want to fight. I'm not saying you got to fight. But look at what the brothers had to do with the black and brown coalition. They had to kick their ass. And then as soon as the Spanish came, they sided with the Spanish to destroy the Aztec Empire. They tricked Montezuma so they could kidnap him. All because we're dumb. We're dumb. We don't ever want to admit that some people are no good. We don't ever want to admit that some people are sneaky. We want to believe that all people nice. Go up, nice. We want to believe that they come. We nice. Everybody nice. No, they're not. Everybody's not nice. Mm-hmm. Everybody's not like you. There's a fear of genetic annihilation among brown people. The mutilated blacks at Monte Alvin indicate that Mongoloid people have long seen blacks as a threat to their genetic supremacy. This is evident in the mutilation of the penises of blacks at Monte Alvin. I wasn't playing. You thought I was kidding.
No, we know you don't kid like that.
Every time I tell you that black penis goes pow, 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 pow.
There it goes again. It's out again. Okay, put it back in there. Look, put it back. Look, get out of there.
They're afraid of you. The only good black man they feel is a man with his penis cut off. The only good black man is the Inuit. They fear you because we take it all. We take it all. You see? These are some of the damn architects and scientists. Yes, we have black architects and scientists who built the pyramids. Look over there. Look over there in the bottom right hand side. You see the Tikal pyramid from Guatemala. You see how when they cut away the outside, you see how the pyramid really looked? Mm-hmm. See how they got that? They got that in a sense. They got that serpentine Olmec figure there. Because it was black people built it. Stop it. Stop mm-hmm. thinking you're dumb. Stop thinking you can't do things. Stop thinking you can't be great. You're a great people. Although blacks built great civilization in Mexico, the Aztecs seem to have been engaged in constant warfare with the Mongoloid Indians. They have left many drawings depicting these wars and their consequences. That's your black and brown coalition. As a result, the local Mongoloid Indians were happy to side with the Spanish to destroy the Aztecs and their cities. This is the same experience today where the brown Latinos support white candidates instead of FBA candidates. I showed you what happened to Stacey Abrams. Instead of her trying to build up her black constituency, instead of her trying to build up her black base, she just thought that black people should vote for her for nothing. Why the hell should you vote for somebody and you ask them to fight for you to get some reparations and they say, "Fuck you, get an abortion." What? Come on.
Come on. That's people. Good. That's good talk right there. That's good people. Understanding.
Love your people. This is the same experience today. But the black and brown Latino support white candidates. In summary, Wakanda Forever is part of the white supremacist Hollywood agenda, promoted by President Biden, who wants FBA to submit to Latino brown leadership in a black and brown coalition. This is an almost impossible demand because Latino people historically have been jealous of blacks who they feel will genetically destroy their race through mixing of the two sets. I showed you what they did in Monte Alban. They want to get that black penis and cut it off before it can go pow, 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 pow.
You can't stop it. You can't stop it. You ain't right. You got people spelling it out here. What are we put it up on the screen? Well, pow, pow, pow. Y'all ain't right. Y'all, he's a bad influence on you. He's a bad influence. Go ahead, Doc.
I'm sorry. And as a result, Mongoloid and African blacks have been engaged in many wars in Mexico since the rise of Monte Alban. These wars were usually the result of the Mongoloids wanting to steal the civilization of the blacks. And that's what they want today. Biden wants to steal away our power. Biden wants us to feel that we are weak. Biden wants us to be, in a sense, weaklings. He wants us to feel that we can't do nothing. That's why they did this to Wakanda. They took
Wakanda. And more than anything, stay in your place and stay in your lane, nigga.
Yeah.
That's what they want. That's the message.
Oh.
Sorry. I had to put it out there.
You said.
I'm a grown-ass reverend. I'm just being real. Come on. I'm a grown-ass reverend.
Damn. You hear that? That's a grown-ass man. A man.
Real talk. I ain't playing.
Contemporary America, Latinos are attacking blacks in Los Angeles and other cities so they can gain political influence, power. As illustrated in the recent case where Latinos were secretly trying to take political power from Los Angeles blacks, you saw it on TV.
Mm-hmm.
Those people in Los Angeles being behind the scenes talking about how they're gonna take away black power, black votes in Los Angeles. They already ran a lot of black people out of Los Angeles and took over a lot of black neighborhoods. Why? In contemporary America. But anyway, don't forget, go to my Clyde Winters Afro History site. I got my videos there. They're waiting for you. Check them out. Learn your history. Don't be like the Wakandians and you'll know where you came from. You know where you came from. You won't be like the Wakandians. Ha 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 ha. Namor.
Namor.
Get into the damn country. Oh! You can contact me on Twitter at Clyde Winters number 8. Again, in a sense, you can order my books at Amazon.com. And most importantly, I want you to go to my Patreon to see the slides. You got to see these slides. You got to see it. Get that PDF. Sir. We're trying to break it down.
You broke it down. You broke it down, Doc. You broke it.
Stop it. Let that brother bring his penis around.
Oh, you're so wrong. There he goes again. He's letting it out again. There he goes again. We've got to cage you. We got to put you in. We got to put. It's time for you to take your pills now. All right.
Yes, sir. Don't arrest.
We got the pump there. You got 5-0 in the house. We're good. We're all right. You're all right.
Yes,
you're
sir.
Safe.
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's funny.
You get Black History Gems essays, podcasts, and those are some of my PDFs. It's in 2 volumes. The reason's in 2 volumes because the book, it was too much for just one. Don't forget, join me on Saturday. It'll be 7 p.m. British time, and I'm going to be talking about the origins of the Hyksos. I'm going to explain how the Hyksos were really Kushites. I'm going to break it down to you. You got to go to https://www.sanonkproductions.com/events. Go there, sign up, be there. Don't be square. I want to talk to you. I want to let you know, family. You see? I want to let you know. Well, anyway, I'm trying to stop. Thank you. Wakanda, the myth of a possible black coalition. I'm not going to go.
Yeah, you are. Yeah, you got, there it goes again. Let him go. Come on now, let me call the popo. Somebody call the popo. Get some yellow tape up here. Where's the police tape? Okay.
Help me, Doc. Help him.
Oh my gosh, that was a. We went from Wakanda to Wacky Wanda. That was just amazing, what you presented, because that was history we did not know. But also, I'm thankful that we now understand the political agenda and was able to see that. And so, you know, on this platform, I'm trying to give you the overall, the view of how and what first sight consciousness looks like. Now, Dr. Marie Charles educated me to the term first sight consciousness. And it's a term that was espoused by the scholars that make up the discipline of Africana phenomenology. And so I think it's Gordon Wilson and Henri Paget, Dr. Marie Charles, of course, Dr. Clyde Winters is involved in that as well. I'm throwing my hat in the ring in terms of researching that discipline as well. But it's important for us to have first sight consciousness with first frequency. Part of our first frequency power is to be able to see what others can't see, to make visible what is invisible, to make seen what is unseen, to make known what is unknown. And that is our superpower. And this class today, Doc, you out of the ballpark. I think you really, really helped, particularly parents and mothers, teach their children how to see.
You know, like it really worked out for the white supremacists, for the child to die. They needed that so that they could, they noticed so many black boys.
To re-narrate the story, because he got so much power in the beginning. They didn't see that coming.
And so many black boys was wearing his uniform. So many black boys, in a sense, was feeling finally that there's somewhere for them to go. I got five boys and one daughter. And the point is this, is that I remember when my sons, when they were little, they'd always want to be superheroes. But my one of my wife's nephew, he always wanted to be Wonder Woman. So you know what he became later. But anyway, he was a good boy. He's a good boy. But he doesn't want that to be emulated. But the thing is that black people just didn't understand until you look at Wakanda Forever, how many white people hated us, hated our kids being so happy. They wanted to let you know, they wanted you to be xenophobic. They wanted to let you know that Wakanda Forever, that Wakanda is not such a strong empire. Mm-hmm. They wanted to let you know that Wakanda was not a place where black people had security and that black people were powerful. They wanted to let you know that some people with spears, come on now.
The people
with spears can come and whoop my ass. And I got damn, I got flying ships. I ride around.
I got the highest technology in the world that allows me to fight aliens all in the entire universe. I can't defeat some dude and with winged feet with spears.
I'm on a boat and they're going to send some water balloons up. And they're gonna almost sink my boat with some water balloons.
You so bad.
You're supposed. They can sink your boat. They can do anything.
Oh my god.
Oh, you're a Negro. Yassa.
Don't go watch this movie with Clyde in the audience. I just know with that don't do that. I know that much. If you're gonna go see it, don't have Clyde, don't buy Clyde, no popcorn for this movie, okay?
Oh, it's like I said, it's a very well-produced movie. It is a beautiful movie. It is the best propaganda. It is almost like Goebbels, who used to be the Nazi propaganda director.
Wow, nice.
If you do go see the movie, explain to your kids, you know, this is important. You know, a lot of people, I taught my kids about white racism. But a lot of people, they always feel afraid that they shouldn't, racism exists. They feel that it's a touchy topic. No, your kids need to know. They need to know. That's why Derek, that's why he created CRT. CRT. And what is CRT? Mm-hmm. CRT, what it teaches you is this. It teaches you that there's white supremacy. It teaches you that the white man hates you. And it teaches you that the white man will do everything he can to hold you down. Mm-hmm. You see? Once your kids understand that, then they can make it in the world. You see? Mm-hmm. If not, they're going to be like a lot of black men in Chicago walking around talking to themselves.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
They probably would. If you just work hard, you can be just as good or better than the European. That was a false statement. Mm-hmm. I can work as hard as hell and they will never let me get on that level. They will never get close to there. They only let me in a sense associate. They will never allow me to assimilate. They will never allow that, because for them to assimilate me, then I might want to take my gun and I will go.
There it goes. All right. Well, that's it. That's it.
They do not want to assist that. But see, the whole point is this, is that you have to understand that we're already talking to you. I showed you that the real Ku Klux Klan was black. I showed you the pyramids these brothers made. And I showed you the black people who those pyramids were made for. Stop it.
Mm-hmm.
Try to get the real history. That's why I gave you a PDF so that you can see the actual place. Understand the psyops. You can still look at these movies as long as you understand it is psyops.
And come with it with first sight consciousness. See? Yes.
Right.
First sight consciousness.
We're always fighting Cades.
Right. You see? We're always at war. Don't think for a minute. We're always at war.
Culturally acquired. Immune identity deficiency syndrome. They want you to stop having a black identity. They do not want you to believe in yourself. They want your kids to feel that they're failures. They want your kids to feel that they cannot be that guy or that gal. They want your kids to feel that if they just kiss that second frequency ass, and now they want you to feel if you just kiss that Hispanic ass, you'll be okay. No, no. I'm FBA. No. I'm not your Negro. I'm FBA.
Come on now. Come on. Ooh, I love that.
And you know, FBA. You know what? I'm better than FBA. FBA ain't shit when it comes to B1, baby. B1.
Come on. Come on.
Black first.
That's a good distinction. Good distinction, too. There's B1, which baby. Is our ancestry. B1. Yes. B1. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. FBA is heritage. B1 is ancestry.
Ancestry.
Beautiful.
Baby.
Beautiful, beautiful, Doc.
We're African people. We're African people. We're African people. We're African people.
All right, one more time, Doc. Pow, pow, pow. Go ahead and get it out your system.
Ah! Oh!
I love it when he does that.
I can't do a damn thing about it, but I'm tired of these people. I told you. They don't want to let you know that you got to love your woman. They want you to think that your woman want to be with another woman. Don't no damn woman want to be with no other woman. Some of them do, but even those women, when they get a stud, they want that stud to wrap that strap on.
And do what now?
They want to put a strap on. I'm not.
And then go. And then what's after that class?
It's kids listening. But anyway.
You did it earlier. Pa 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 pa, right?
Yeah. But see, that dildo don't go pa 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 pa.
No, it does not. You say okay, walk away. Let's just walk away, and then we this was just a grown ass doctor, a grown ass reverend up in here having conversations with a grown ass family. Okay, that's what we do.
Let me pick some cotton. Let me pick some cotton. All you Negroes out there, drop the body.
You ain't right. You ain't right. Yeah, don't listen to us. Don't listen to us at all. Don't listen to us at all. No, yeah, we don't know.
People. We're unique people.
Oh, that's funny.
I don't care what those people do. I remember Wakanda. I remember T'Challa.
Yes.
You can try to take away my heroes. You can try to take my grandkids and make them think they ain't nothing but a piece of dookie under my shoe.
Right. But truly, Wakanda forever.
Wakanda forever, baby.
Truly.
In the real Wakanda, ain't no Namor.
No, not at all.
Wakanda. Ain't no Telecon gonna get us on the edge of the ship and push yourself.
That's right. That's right.
I'm a black man. You're a black woman. Wakanda forever. Wakanda forever.
Well, Doc, this is the part where I have to ask you, would you like to do the Wakandian affirmation of power? Oh, okay. See the sound went out again like that, fam. See, I don't think this is the internet though. I think this is Clyde. I think his voice went out. That's what it is. Yeah, see? Exactly. See, now this is the part where you lean over to the side and start disappearing from the camera. Mm-hmm. See there? I knew it wasn't the internet. It was Clyde all along. Here we go, fam. We're gonna do our affirmation of power. Oh, this man is crazy. I love you so much. We love you so much.
Reverend Matthew, huh? Are there any questions?
I don't see any questions, but everybody's just completely floored. They enjoy when you act up. I just don't want you to know that. No questions as of yet. And if so, let's save them for the comments and have you go in and answer the questions to the people in the comments, because that's what I want all of y'all to do is to chat it up, comment it up, share this doggone thing. It's over it's like 220 some of you on here live. So that was wonderful. Oh, Akil, he says he has a question. All right, Akil, what's the question? Type it in, bro, as quick as you can. he got you. Will you close tonight, Clyde? Will you close us out, Clyde? That's the question. Akil, you see? See, Akil? You can't stop him. Something's wrong with him. He's just wrong that way. He's just wrong. He loves it when I do it, and that's what I do. You ain't got no sense, Clyde. You don't. All right. So this is what we're gonna do, fam. Despite Clyde's loss of voice, and he actually froze. This is really showing you they don't want Clyde. This is hilarious. So in light of that, fam, we are going to give thanks to our ancestors, but more importantly, we're gonna give. Oh, I'm sure. Yeah, exactly. Like that. Yeah, right. Okay. Yeah, I don't know if it's the internet or if it's you, Clyde. You're so wrong right now. You're so wrong. That's okay. I still love you. But I want us to celebrate the Killmonger ancestor in us, the one that will not die, that will only multiply, the one that will not give up, let up, or shut up until Amma takes him up. That's the spirit that we want to have. That's the ancestral realm that we want to be on when we go to these movies. And again, this frequency, constant propaganda, frequency interruption that is on us. It is our ancestors. It is our love and our understanding of being able to listen, to absorb, to download what our ancestors are giving us, to be able to see what is in front of us and to have first sight consciousness, to put an African eye on it. When we put an African eye, that pineal gland on it, we see it for what it really is and what it really can do. So that being said, we simply affirm, I am one with first frequency.
I am one with first frequency.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the firstborn people.
I am one with the firstborn people.
I am one with the only one.
I am one with the only one.
Ashe.
Ashe.
And so it is. Whew, that was a powerful one, fam. All right, you know what to do, fam. Get that PDF. Let's go and let's get this information out. Educate your children. If you want to go back and watch it again for the second time, if you watched it first, at least this time, go back with that first sight consciousness on it and be able to educate your community. Bring out the people and educate them so they know what they're looking for, so you can see the agenda that is not coming, but is actually in place already, and that now they are initiating more and more. We absolutely love and appreciate Dr. Winters. We'll see you guys next time.